अज्ञान तिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजनशलाकय चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। नमः ॐ विष्णुपादाय श्री गौर प्रियमूर्तये श्रीमते भक्ति वल्लभा तीर्थ गोस्वामिने नमः। पतित पावन परम करुणामय परमाराध्यतम शिल गुरुदेव नित्य लीला प्रविष्टो विष्णुपाद श्री श्रीमद भक्ति वल्लभ तीर्थ गोस्वामी महाराज जी के श्रीपाद पद्म में असंख्य कोटि साष्टांग दंडवत प्रणाम करते हुए उनकी अहेतु की कृपा प्रार्थना करता हूँ। परमाराध्य शिक्षा गुरु नित्य लीला प्रविष्टोम विष्णुपाद शिल भक्ति विज्ञान भारती गोस्वामी महाराज जी एवं शिल भक्ति निकेतन तुर्याश्रमी गोस्वामी महाराज जी के श्रीपाद पद्म में असंख्य कोटि साष्टांग दंडवत प्रणाम करते हुए उनकी अहेतु की कृपा प्रार्थना करता। बाय द मर्सी ऑफ मोस्ट रिवर्ड शिल गुरुदेव वी हैव बीन डिस्कसिंग हियर द डिवाइन पास टाइम्स ऑफ शिल हरिदास ठाकुर in relation to the glory of the holy name. So as we have discussed, this lady Lakshahira, this young prostitute whose heart is completely transformed by the mercy of Srila Haridas Thakur, her heart is completely transformed and now she is begging forgiveness from Srila Haridas Thakur. And what she is requesting? She is requesting him with all the humility. She became very humble now and requesting him to enlighten her. She is asking, please enlighten me. And how she can overcome the miseries of this transitory life. It's not permanent, it's transitory. So she is requesting Srila Haridas Thakur, please enlighten me. Listening to her sincere approach, Haridas Thakur, he says, Gharer Dravya Brahmana Karadan. You know, you have to give up all those activities by which you are committing sin, by which sin is generated. Not only that, you have to give up all the money which you have accumulated by this sinful activities. That is also very important. We may think sometimes people would like to accept donations from people, those who have earned that money through their sinful activities. And people, they think that no problem, if the money is used in the service of the devotee, then it will be purified. It is true, but this is not applicable in the case of ordinary devotees. If the money is used for the service of some paramahansas, some great acharyas, then only there is the possibility of purification of that sin, unless sin is never purified. Especially those who are still kind of practitioners and they are bound in the three modes of material nature. Serving such people with that money is not going to solve the purpose, is not going to purify the consciousness of the person, or is not going to help to wash out the sin or sinful reaction. This is what we have to understand. So it's always good to utilize the money only coming from the bona fide devotees or a very pious people. It doesn't mean that we don't accept any donations from other people, those who are engaged in sinful activities. It is wise to accept donations from the people, those who are engaged in sinful activities, but it is wise to not spend that money for any of the individual purpose. Better that money is being spent only for the service of the Lord. Then only the money is purified, the donations are purified. If not, whoever accepts, they have to take the sin, they have to take some part of the sin by which the money is earned. So Haridas Thakur, he says, even though today you might have realized, understood and decided to give up these sinful activities, but actually the money till today which you have earned is part of that sinful activities only. So you should not keep that money for yourself. So what to do? Gharer dravya brahmana kardan, donate everything for the service of brahmanas. Yehi ghare asi tumi karah vishram, come to this place which I am staying here, this hut where I am staying, stay here, tumi karah vishram, don't go back to your home, this is your home from today onwards, you stay here. And then you take shelter in this hut. And then what to do? Nirantara naam karo tulsi sevan. Always serve Tulsi Maharani and chant the holy name. Just chant the holy name constantly and worship Tulsi Maharani always. Achirat pavetumi krishnera charan. What he is saying, in short time, I am sure, have no doubt in my words, that in a very short time you will attain the lotus feet of Supreme Lord Sri Krishna. These are the instructions given by Srila Haridas Thakur to that lady, as she requested him to enlighten her so that she can overcome the miseries of this material world, this momentary life. And now, giving such instructions, Srila Haridas Thakur, he left that place forever. Haridas Thakur, even before, he said, I am not supposed to stay here. The only plan for me to stay here was only for one day. Because I understood the intention of yours as well as the intention of Ramachandra Khan. So just only to deliver you from this adverse condition, I stayed here for these 3 days. So now it's your turn, you stay here peacefully and then engage yourself in the chanting of holy name, serving Tulsi Maharani. And Srila Haridas Thakur, he left that place. Haridas Thakur, we have to understand that Haridas Thakur, he is very soft, at the same time he is very hard as mountain rock. That's why it's difficult, it's impossible to disturb a person like Srila Haridas Thakur. His heart is addicted by the drinking of deep nectar of divine love. He is in addiction. He is already addicted. When a person is intoxicated, then how it is possible to give him something? It is not possible. So Haridas Thakur, his heart is addicted by the nectar of holy name. So the highest mellow, the highest rasa, which he is drinking, the topmost of the addiction which he is addicted to, then whatever are the lower addictions, they can never change the heart of that person or the personality. Like all those worldly addictions are in the mode of ignorance. But Haridas Thakur is addicted to the holy name, which is in the mode of Shuddha Sattva. It's not bound by three modes of material nature. One who is always drinking the nectar which is on the transcendental platform, how it is possible for such persons to come down, or how it is possible for any such person who can try to influence such personalities and try to change their heart? So it was not possible, especially in the case of devotees like Srila Haridas Thakur. Whatever efforts that led this young prostitute may do, but still it's not possible for a person like Haridas Thakur to fall a victim to her lustful desires. Not possible. This is one of the very big difference we can see in this world of genuine devotees and the people. Genuine devotees of the Lord and the ordinary people. This difference can be seen. Ordinary people are so conditioned that they can be easily carried away by any kinds of deeds, by any kinds of activities, by any kinds of things. But a pure devotee is completely untouched and remains like a rock solid, like a mountain. So this was seen in the life of Srila Haridas Thakur. And what it is saying, those who are treading on the path of devotion, ever engaged in taking the holy name of the Lord, do not fall a prey to sins, even when such sins gather close to them. Like that, many people, they say that, you know, what to do, everywhere these people, they are only performing sinful activities, so how can we survive from such situations? Here it is said very clearly, a person whoever are engaged in chanting of the holy name, it's quite natural, without any specific effort, it's natural because it becomes their default nature to be the devotee of the Lord. So whatever is against the standard of being a devotee of the Lord can never divert their attention or mind. So even those sins, they even come together, but still this person is never affected by all those sins. Such great personalities are beyond the temptations, beyond the influence of the temptations, however irresistible they may be to others. For others it may be irresistible, they can't control themselves, for them it may not be possible, not so easy. But for devotees, it's least influential thing. Like we can see Vishwamitra, he was influenced by the damsel of the apsara of Swargaloka, Menaka. Menaka used to be one apsara from heaven, which was sent by Indra to spoil the tapasya performed by Vishwamitra. She came there and twice he got moved away. He got moved away by her beauty. But Srila Haridas Thakur, he was continuously watching her for 3 days, but still nothing happened in him. In return, that lady got completely changed. we can see even a person who has performed 60,000 years of severe austerities, but still his heart was not completely transformed and he got carried away by the beauty of Apsara. But where in the life of Haridas Thakur, he was not at all influenced or affected by any kind of act or words of this lady. In return, he transformed her life completely and made her a devotee of the Lord. This young woman, she is very fortunate, who has become the recipient of the mercy of Srila Haridas Thakur. What she did, now she obeyed the instructions of her guru. And how she obeyed, they are the last words, final words. There is like never challenging. Guru Agya Avicharaniya. There is like no second thought when whatever is spoken by Sri Guru, they are the words which are final. They are considered to be the final words. So now, by the mercy of her spiritual master, what happened? She could understand the position of beauty, wealth, etc. in this changing world. As it is said by Shankaracharya, Nakuru Dhanajana Yavana Garvam. Don't be pride of these things, of your money, name, fame and all those things. Why? Harati Nimeshat Kalahi Sarvam. Time is so powerful, it can destroy everything in any moment. Anything can be destroyed in any moment. Nothing remains constant in this transitory world. So that's why don't be pride. Ultimately, you have to suffer if you show pride. And also our acharyas, in their kirtan, he says, Shri Guru Kripai Bhengeche Swapan Bhujechiyakon Tumai Apon. Now I got to understand, I realized that Tumai Apon, you are mine and I am yours, that's all. You and I, nothing else in between. And now how I understood this? Shri Guru Kripai, by the mercy of Shri Guru. By the mercy of Shri Guru, we understand that this world is momentary and nothing in this world is going to remain with us forever. Any moment, anything can happen. Our most revered Srila Gurudev would very often say this, any moment we may die, any moment we may die. So what to do? Prepare yourself to depart from this transitory world and enter into the abode of the Lord. Chant the holy name. Guru Maharaj would always emphasize on this particular point of chanting the holy name, because ayu ati alpa din krametaha haikshin, that age is very less and also it's slowly degrading. We are losing our age. Not only losing our age, the strength in the body is also coming down. We don't have that energy. We don't have that strength, nothing. So as we are becoming weak, how we will attain perfection in our life, how we will attain Godhead, that is not possible. That's why what we have to do is, when you have energy, when you are strong enough, the first thing you do is to surrender to the Lord, take shelter of His lotus feet. So now, what she did, she also understood by the mercy of Sri Guru. We can't understand this world to be useless if we don't, if we are not bathed by the mercy of Sri Guru. The mercy of Sri Guru only enlightens us, opens our eyes. We are in ignorance. That's why we always glorify Sri Guru with this pranam mantra, Ajnana Timirandhasya Jnananjana Shalakaya. I am in ignorance. And Gurudev enlightens me through the knowledge, through the vision, and then transforms my life. A person who is sleeping and watching a dream and enjoying that life in the dream, but the truth is totally different from what he is watching. And who helps us to understand this is Sri Guru. He comes and wakes us up. Wake up. As we wake up, to our surprise, we see that we are now in a completely different world, which as compared to the world of dreams. So the one who is awakening us, the one who is helping us to understand this, the one who, by whose teachings we understand, we realize all those things, that is Sri Guru. So this lady, by the mercy of her most revered Gurudev, who enlightened her, who brought her from ignorance to knowledge, Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya, who has brought her from ignorance to knowledge, and she now realized what is the position of beauty. This beauty is not going to remain forever. This wealth is not going to remain forever. Everything is changing in this world. Then things are changing, then how these things can remain constant? These are also the part of this world. So now what happened? Without any least hesitation, she is not hesitating anymore now, because a person with in an enlightened state have no fear of anything. Fear remains only as long as we are conditioned. The moment we are enlightened with knowledge, there is no question of having any kind of hesitation or any kind of fear. So now with no hesitation, what she did? She decided to fulfill the desires of her spiritual master. So what he did, or she did, all her wealth she distributed to the brahmanas because she was thinking that because she is a very young lady, very beautiful lady, so that's why beautiful complexion. So what she did, she shaved her head. She shaved her head so not to look that beautiful anymore now. Because she knows that because of the beauty only, she was attracting people and then taking their money, being a prostitute. So she knows what kind of attraction is there. That's why she doesn't want to look attracted. So she shaved her head completely. And now with a single piece of cloth, like you can see this in Bengal and Odisha, all those places, the village women, they try to cover themselves with only one piece of cloth, like long cloth, like sari, and then they cover like that. So this lady also, with one long piece of cloth, she covered her body, and then what she did, stayed in that place only where Haridas Thakur has left for her. Srila Haridas Thakur, who is her merciful master, who is the merciful monk of that time, Srila Haridas Thakur, she start to live in that cell, in that hut. And what she is doing? Obeying the commands of her spiritual master. He gave her the command, sit and chant the holy name, serve Tulsi. These are the commands he gave to her. So already whatever he told, that distribute the money, don't keep anything for yourself, that is not good. She did that, and then he told her, stay in this place which I am leaving for you, and then chant the holy name. Now she is every day chanting the holy name, 300,000 names, like guru, like disciple. So Haridas Thakur is the spiritual master who was chanting 3 lakh Harinam in one day. And this lady because she is also her disciple. So she started chanting 3 lakh Harinam every day now. She worshipped the Tulsi every day unfailingly. Not like one day she is doing, other day she is not doing. No, every day she is worshipping Tulsi Maharani. And what she did, she has given up eating all the delicious meals. She is not eating anything which is delicious. She was satisfied with uncooked food. Means now she switched to raw food. She is not cooking, because if she has to chant 300,000 holy names every day, how it is possible for her to cook and to eat? It's not possible. So now she quit cooking, and also she quit eating delicious food. What she is doing is, she is only depending on the uncooked food. Raw food means raw vegetables and also fruits, all those things which are available in the forest. She is depending on that only now. And also most of the time, in many, almost all the tithis, she is fasting. She is fasting in all the tithis. So by performing all these things, she could easily control over her senses in a very short time. That is very special thing we have to understand. She realized, she understood very nicely, and but she also had to put what she understood in the practical application. So when she applied this in the practical application, then the transformation of life has come. Life got completely transformed after that. Before also it got transformed, but she needs to repent and then practice. That is very important. Even after realizing, but if she was not practicing, if she was not following the instructions of Haridas Thakur, again her life would have come back to the same place where it has started. That's why it is very important that when we take Sangha, when we take association of devotees, that should be apratihata. That should be in a constant flow. Association is not possible like a moment of association, after that we remain in this material world. As long as our life is not completely transformed, in fact, as long as we don't attain the Godhead, we have to be in the association of Guru Vaishnavas all the time. I still remember Srila Bharati Goswami Maharaj, he says that I don't want to imagine myself in a condition free from the association of Vaishnavas, because it is not safe. If we are not in the association of Vaishnavas, for sure our life will be spoiled completely. Our life will be completely spoiled. We become independent and then we don't feel like worshipping. We don't feel like following proper parampara or anything. So that's why it is very important. What happened? All these methods helped this lady to perfectly control. Why she has to control? Because she has to follow the words of her spiritual master. If not, she would not be able to follow the teachings of her spiritual master. He said, chant the holy name Sarv Tulsi. Stay here. If a person has to live a life so simple, then person has to practice to live a very simple lifestyle. Always surrounded by the object of senses. If a person is still trying to pretend himself to be an elevated devotee or something, that is practically very difficult. So now this lady, what she did, she controlled herself completely, and then slowly, slowly, this unalloyed devotion, love for the Supreme Lord, awoken, has sprouted in her heart. Like Bhakti Lata Beej, the seed now started sprouting. By the mercy of Sri Guru, we receive this Bhakti Lata Beej. We have to be the farmer and then sow the seed within the heart. As the seed is sown and as we are nourishing the seed with the help of Shravan and Kirtan, then the seed starts to sprout. So in the same way, she took the holy name mantra from Srila Haridas Thakur, and by the mercy of Srila Haridas Thakur, what happened? Her life is transformed. In the transformed state of life, she is chanting the holy name and also following all the prescribed regulative principles. Slowly, slowly, what happened? She has become a very strong devotee of the Lord, as this unalloyed, unadulterated devotional love for the divine couple has sprouted in her heart. And everyone is surprised to know this, that how come the life of a prostitute changed completely. Everyone is surprised, and now people want to go and have her darshan. So people, they keep on coming. So, but how she has attained such great position? It is said only by the mercy of her spiritual master. So when this news has spread on all the directions, devotees, all those saintly persons from different parts of the country would visit her and bless her. The inhabitants of the surrounding villages were greatly astonished by the wonderful capacity of Srila Haridas Thakur that brought about a miraculous change in the life of a mere prostitute of sinful actions. This we have to understand. People are surprised. But for Haridas Thakur, it is not surprising, because this is one of the very menient, this is one of the small mercy, effect of the small mercy of the holy name, glory of the holy name. So Haridas Thakur, he know, Nam Prabhu, when he becomes merciful, you get Krishna. How we get Krishna? We get Krishna only when the Nam Prabhu becomes merciful. That is the speciality. The holy name is potent enough to attract the Supreme Lord and bind him here. And what to talk of transforming the life of one particular lady? It is nothing special in it. But the people, those who don't know the glory of the holy name, they are very surprised, and also they are like very surprised to see the glorious life of Srila Haridas Thakur, who by his mercy transformed the life of this lady. Haridas Thakur, if he is merciful, he can bestow the pure loving devotional service of the Lord. Lord has to come and Lord has to accept the person to whom Haridas Thakur wants to bestow that love. But here it's only about transformation of life. This is one of the part, not only this is one of the part of the glory of holy name. But for the worldly people, this itself is a very surprising thing. So what they are thinking, that how this person has changed completely, this lady who is a prostitute, who has very bad intentions towards the society, whose all her activities are completely sinful. But all these people, those who hated her once, today they all are falling on her feet because she has taken shelter of the holy in him. Not only she got transformed, she became a very great devotee. That is the speciality of Srila Haridas Thakur. He doesn't change the life. He changes the life completely and in such a way that the person will have no option other than taking absolute shelter in the lotus feet of the holy name. By the mercy of Sri Guru, what happens? This lady, one time she was a kind of lady by whom everyone is falling down in this world. Of course, it's natural thing that if a person goes to a prostitute, it's quite natural that he will fall from his standards, culture, everything. You can see that how Ajamil also, when he got attracted to that prostitute, his life also completely changed, because before he was the topmost among the Brahmanas, following everything very in a ritualistic way, very systematic way. But after he got attracted to that lady, immediately his life got spoiled. So these association with prostitutes definitely spoil the life of the person. But today, that same lady, by the mercy of her spiritual master and by the mercy of the holy name, has become qualified that she can release all these people from the terrible grips of this worldly afflictions and help them to engage in the transcendental service of the Supreme Lord. She can easily help them so that they can engage in the transcendental service of the Supreme Lord. And all this has happened only by the mercy of the most merciful monk, Srila Haridas Thakur. People bowed with great reverence whenever they spoke of him. Of course, such great personalities, when someone speaks about them, immediately, naturally, our head bows down. So Haridas Thakur is such a kind of personality. And what happened here? The above incident of converting the young woman of bad character to the position of spiritual preceptor has got in it many lessons to teach. Now, with this incident, there are many teachings, there are many lessons that one can learn by the life of this prostitute and by her meeting with Srila Haridas Thakur. It's not just a story, there is a teaching, there is a message. So, what kind of transformation from a prostitute who makes everyone fall? But now she has become a spiritual preceptor, guru, who helps other fallen people, who can rescue other fallen people from their fallen condition. So it said, what it is in the first instance, it is spreading the glory of holy name. In the first case, it is spreading the glories of the holy name. Thy name be glorified. The holy name is glorified. So everything happened only because of the holy name, because of listening to the holy name from the lips of Srila Haridas Thakur. When the holy name is being heard from the lips of a pure devotee, it naturally affects our consciousness, because our consciousness, our true nature, is being the servant of the Lord. So our true nature is awakened when the holy name is coming from the lips of a pure devotees. That is the speciality. So that's why here it is about the glory of the holy name, the first thing, and then the reception of the holy name delivers everyone from the worst of sins. So if there is a sinner, if a person is a sinner and also not an ordinary sinner, he is very good in committing worst of the sins. But the holy name is so potent, is so divine, that the moment a person sincerely or normally, generally also chants the holy name, like Helaya, means in a very normal mood, if a person can chant the holy name, his life will also completely delivered, rescued. He will be completely free from all those worst sinful activities. The chanting of the name delivered her from all sins and created in her. So, what happened? The chanting of the holy name, delivered her from all the sins. The holy name delivered. No other karma has the capacity to deliver us from all those sinful reactions other than the holy name. Other than the holy name. So now the holy name has delivered this lady from all those sinful reactions, sinful activities, and also created in her, like brought in her, a kind of repentive mood. She is now repenting that what I have done till today, I need to change myself. Why I had spoiled my life completely, this is not correct. I need to change myself. When a person has no repentance for any of the deeds he has performed in the past, then there is no possible that complete change comes in his life. Not possible. The person will not change after that. So repentance has to be there. So now the holy name has brought this repentance, this pain in her heart for all those past sinful deeds she has performed. And what it does, it has awakened this desire to take shelter in the utterance of the name, in the chanting of the holy name. So not only she is repenting, she is also having this intense desire to chant the holy name, to utter the holy name of the Lord. That is also awakened only by the mercy of the holy name. And only in the company of pure devotees like Srila Haridas Thakur. Which in course of short period favored her, the desire to chant the holy name and the desire to take shelter in the lotus feet of the holy name has favored her in a very short time. What to experience spiritual rapture and divine realizations. To experience these spiritual raptures, it's not possible for any person who doesn't give up any of his past desires, past deeds, or who doesn't repent for his life. There should be repentance. Begging for forgiveness should be there. If a person who doesn't want to beg forgiveness, who doesn't want to surrender, who doesn't have the desire to chant, can never ever experience any kind of spiritual realizations. So, through the life of Srila Haridas Thakur, through this incident with this prostitute, we can come to know that how Srila Haridas Thakur has transformed her life, how the holy name has affected on her, and how the holy name has transformed her completely. A sadhak, a practitioner, should perform proper sadhana under the shelter of the bona fide spiritual authority. Then only by the mercy of the spiritual authority and the sadhana prescribed by that authority will definitely help us to deliver ourselves from this most adrenal condition of our life, worst condition of our life, and then help us to reach and attain the loving devotional service of the divine couple. The young woman appears before us with a heavy load of sin. She can be well compared with any other individual of this work. An unusual greed for money and so now the same way we can compare with any other, she can be very well compared with any other individual of this kind of work, of this kind of deeds. And now unnatural greed, it's an unnatural greed, it's not natural greed, it is unnatural greed. Natural greed is for Harikatha. Natural greed is only for Harikatha. Natural greed is only for devotion. It's all unnatural greeds, because it is not there in the soul. Soul doesn't have greed, especially the greed for enjoying the worldly things. It is unnatural. So that's why we have to understand unnatural greed for money, and also the tendency to satisfy the sensuous, the senses, can be easily noted among the present day. Today, our agenda is only to satisfy our senses. Our agenda is only to attain money. People today are only struggling to get money, least bothered about their health, least bothered about their culture, least bothered about any spirituality whatsoever it is, or the family, personal life, anything. They are only and only engaged in getting money. They work too hard with the solo desire to get money and nothing else. And there is, through the help of money, they always believe that we can enjoy and fulfill all our desires. So now, but what is the difference between this particular lady and others? We can compare her activities with the activities of others, but what is the difference? There is one very big difference between others and her. That is, in spite of her madness, she is completely mad for wealth. That's why she has accepted this proposal, even though others did not, but she has accepted this proposal because she is completely mad for money as well as for her passions. But what is the good quality which she has? The only good quality which she possessed is she has a kind of natural respect for the sadhus and tulsi. She has a natural respect for the sadhus and tulsi. That's why as she approached, she was not instructed by anyone to pay pranams to Tulsi Maharani and also to Haridas Thakur. She was not asked by anyone. She herself voluntarily did pranams to him She voluntarily did everything. She came and she did pranams to Tulsi Maharani. She offered pranams to Haridas Thakur. That's her natural quality, natural instinct which she has. In fact, we can understand that to be her assert, that to be her capital. This we can gather from her behavior before Sri Haridas Thakur. So we can understand for last 3 days she has been doing that coming there, offering pranams to Tulsi Maharani and to Haridas Thakur. Today the biggest problem is we don't have the heart to bow down near Tulsi, near Vaishnav, near Guru or anyone, because our attitude doesn't allow us to bow down. Because we don't consider anyone as Vaishnav first of all, then how it is possible for us that we will have some realization? Everyone has to pay pranams to each other. That is the culture of Gaudiya Vaishnavas. That is the culture of Indian Vedic wisdom. Here everyone bow down to other person. If you go and see in Maharashtra, the people, those who follow the path of Varkari line, they have this habit that they offer pranams to each other regularly. So that is one of the very important activity we have to perform. The moment we offer ourselves, we pay pranams, we will naturally become the possessor of good health, beauty and age and knowledge. So one gets all these 4 things only by paying pranams, by bowing down in front of the elevated personalities. We are so experts these days in this world that according to our conviction, there is no one elevated. Only what our ignorant brain says, that only Gurudev is elevated, after that all other Vaishnavas, Guru Vargas, senior God brothers and Vaishnavas from other organizations, they all are useless now for us. That is the mindset which people are making in their own sterile minds. That's why they are unable to progress, even though they may be very good in memorizing so many verses, and also they may be very good in a very kind of knowledgeable presentations of the scriptures, but in the name of humility they are becoming completely useless. According to them, others have no realization, others have no devotion at all, nothing. And if their mind says someone is realized, whether the person is or not, definitely they go behind them. Basically, being the slaves of ignorance, they are not inclined to surrender, to bow down near any superior personalities. As a result, they are unable to experience anything in their life other than some general information, basic information. But this person, this lady, being a prostitute, but because of her natural respect for sadhus and Tulsi Maharani, she came and then very patiently did pranams and sitting there and listening to him. Because of her desire for money and because of her passion, she is not hesitating to spoil the character of such a great personality. But her nature, she is she has this quality of paying due respects to the sadhus and to Tulsi Maharani. The conception of morality and immortality as understood by the people of this material world is to be completely and favorably molded for one's spiritual progress. Extremists in either of these are sure to meet with and utter failure in the spiritual path. We have to understand this. What a person has to do The woman in this incident did not approach Srila Haridas Thakur with a kind of philosophical arguments. She did not come that I have some inquiry, please help me, nothing. And also she was not even a scholar in any sense. She is just a prostitute, ignorant lady. She doesn't have a any kind of scholarly knowledge in any sense. And she was neither convinced by anyone, nor she was converted by any kinds of miracles or superpowers. Nothing. It's completely normal. Then how she got transformed? If she is not approaching with a philosophical argument, there is no parikrishna, and then she is not a scholar, that scholarly person, after she came to the devotee and she observed him and then her life transformed, no. And also she is not convinced by anyone, no one tried to convince her. Not that she discussed some things and then she got convinced. And also, like no superpower or some unnatural thing has converted her. Nothing has happened. What happened? Her reformation was brought about by the simple method. What is that simple method? Listening to the holy name and its repetition. This is what she has done. And also, and her natural receptive disposition completed the work. She is naturally receptive, and now what she did, she is repeating what she has received from the lips of a pure devotee. This is her speciality. This is her speciality. What she did, she was listening. What Srila Haridas Thakur is chanting, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. She is sitting there and then she is listening. And listening, as she is listening, like you, we can understand this. We also have this nature, but we don't pay attention to it. If we are listening to some jokes or some songs or some music, anything, slowly, slowly we also try to recite behind it. Whatever we listen repeatedly, if we listen repeatedly, then naturally we also keep reciting it. So like this, she is sitting there all night. Not just 1 hour or half hour, she is just sitting there all night and reciting, listening to what Haridas Thakur is chanting. And at one point, she also started repeating the name of the Lord. As a result, her life was completely transformed. So, what it is said? A spiritual aspirant must possess a natural instinct to pay due respect to sadhus and other godly objects. So this is very important. If a person is spiritual aspirant, one who is not a spiritual aspirant, one who doesn't have any desire for that, but still simply by offering due respects to a pure sadhu like Srila Haridas Thakur, And then following him, life goes completely transformed. So that's why here it is said, if you really want to be benefited, if a person wants to be benefited, what the person has to do is to develop a desire to pay due respects to those pure souls, to those great personalities. They must never underestimate them on any ground. At any point, they should not underestimate the devotees. No one should underestimate the devotees. Not only because I am not inspired or convinced by the teachings or the appearance or the lifestyle of the devotee. If I underestimate them, then that means I am only digging hole, digging pit for my own self. I may not be able to understand the devotee because I am conditioned that Vaishnava Charitra Aprakrita Sada, the life of a pure devotee is purely transcendental. And Aprakrita Vastu Nahi Prakriti Gochar. This transcendental thing, how it can be understood by a person who is fully engaged or enveloped by this material world and worldly desires? Not possible. One who doesn't know, one who is ignorant, may be possible that he will be liberated by the mercy of Guru Vaishnavas. But one whose intelligence is perverted, there is least possible for the rescue of such person. You are intelligent, you know that you should adore the devotees, you should adore Vaishnavas. You should not discriminate them with any kinds of differentiations. And also you should not separate them or speculate them in the name of any organizations. Not limit them in the name of any organizations. Just surrender to them and then follow their teachings. But if a person doesn't follow this, and if a person try to walk on his own ideology, such persons with perverted intelligence are the losers, not the ones, those who are ignorant. As the knowledge is awakened, ignorance will disappear. But once the intelligence is perverted, it's not so easy for that to bring back on the track. These people with perverted intelligence, they only follow what their sterile brains advise them. They don't want to follow Guru Vargas, they don't want to follow Vaishnavas or anyone or any proper Siddhanta. They try to come to the conclusions of the bona fide scriptures by their own debate, even though it is very clearly mentioned, Tarko Apratishtita. Through logic, the truth can never be established. But these people, they try to present various logics to establish the truth, instead of surrendering onto the truth. Such people are the losers. So intelligent person, what they do, a sincere spiritual aspirant, what he does is try to pay due respects to the sadhus and all other things. They will never ever underestimate the pure devotee. With reverence and with firm faith in their words, what they have to do, they must prepare themselves so that they can follow the instructions of sadhus. They can follow the instructions of those pure souls, who spiritual aspirants. That's why a sincere spiritual aspirant, even though he like or he don't like, he will definitely follow the teachings instructed by the pure sadhus. Because he knows, by following their footsteps and their teachings, I will be rescued. If not, there is no other possibility of being rescued from this world and worldly afflictions. This is what in otherwise called श्रद्धा. व्हाट इज श्रद्धा? श्रद्धा मीन्स दिस, फॉलोइंग द टीचिंग्स ऑफ द प्योर सोल्स, गिविंग देम ड्यू रेस्पेक्ट्स. दैट्स व्हाई आफ्टर श्रद्धा इज साधु संग. फॉर दैट इफ वी वॉन्ट टू परफॉर्म साधु संग, वी शुड हैव श्रद्धा. एंड हाउ द श्रद्धा कम्स? श्रद्धा ऑल्सो कम्स थ्रू साधु संग ओनली. बिफोर वॉट वी आर डूइंग, वी मे बी थिंकिंग टू बी साधु संग, बट एक्चुअली इट इज द थिंग विच हेल्प्स अस टू गेट श्रद्धा, फेथ. आफ्टर फेथ वेन वी एसोसिएट विथ डिवोटी, देन इट इज साधु संग, नॉट बिफोर दैट. वेन देर इज नो फेथ, देन हाउ वी कैन से दैट इट इज एसोसिएशन? If there is no faith in the relation, then we can't say that the person is father and son, the person is guru and disciple, the person is mother and son, the person is wife and husband, nothing. Because there is no faith in the relation. The moment the faith in the relation disappears and the relation breaks completely, it's broken. The relation is broken completely. In the same way, here there is no such faith. So, in the initial stages of sadhu sangha, we are only practicing and preparing ourselves to have shraddha in sadhus, in the pure souls. So, that is addressed here as shraddha. Real faith is the outcome of one's previous unconscious association with true devotees of the Lord. So, knowingly or unknowingly, whatever we have done, association with the devotees of the Lord in the past, past means it can be till the last moment of our life, that results the real Shraddha. After Shraddha, Sadhu Sangh comes. So this is the special gift, this Shraddha is the special gift. What it does? That it enable a person to come in contact with sadhus and hear their soul-stirring words. The words coming from the lips of the sadhu is soul-stirring. So that helps the soul, awakening of the soul. The words emanating from the lips of pure devotees are not material sound. Srila Guru Maharaj would used to say this, that these are the words from the Vaikuntha, the words of Vaikuntha, not from this material world. We may think like we speak the same way they are speaking. When the pure devotees are speaking, however they are speaking, wherever they are speaking, the words, they carry the potency of the Supreme Abode, because the Lord is residing in their heart, and the Lord in the form of holy name residing in their heart, and the Lord in His Swaroop also residing in their heart. So, Naam Prabhu, He appears through each and every holy name which is coming out from the lips of such great personalities. That's why it is said these are not considered as the material sound, that is transcendental sound. And that transcendental sound is capable of producing the most marvelous experience in the heart of the submissive aspirant. That is the listener. If a person is submissive and sincerely listening, he is a sincere listening and also he is submissive, then he can experience an amazing transformation in his life. We can see how Parikshit Maharaj, simply by sitting on the bank of river Ganga, listening to the transcendental words coming out from the lips of Shukadev Goswami, his life, how it has completely changed. He Shraddha Rati Bhakti Anukrimishyati. It comes in a flow. Shraddha, form faith, and then Rati, and then Bhakti, devotion. All three appears gradually, one by one. So we can see this in the life of Parikshit Maharaj also. We may not have Shraddha, no problem. Just go for Sadhu Sangha and sit and listen to the words spoken by the sadhus. Just sit and listen. As a result, the words are coming from the transcendental abode. They enter into our heart and then they start to transform our consciousness, purify our consciousness and make place for devotion. One must always follow the preceptor's instructions which are given for his spiritual uplift. If the spiritual master gives all his instructions only for the spiritual upliftment of his disciples, so the sincere, the spiritual aspirant has to take all those instructions for his own benefit. Unless we follow the above instructions, our progress in spiritual path remains ever blocked. It is blocked forever. It is never revived. It is never opened for any such person if the person is never following the teachings of his spiritual master for his spiritual benefit. Or in fact, if he is not following the teachings of a pure monk, then it is not possible for any kind of upliftment. Forget about the spiritual upliftment. It is even not possible for any kind of spiritual material upliftment also. Material in the sense moral, cultural, ethical upliftment. Not technical or monetary upliftments. Thank you very much. We shall discuss remaining Harikatha tomorrow. Jai Radhe Shyam.